Evaluating sources is an important part of information literacy, but it is not a clear-cut process. Because people often use good and bad to describe sources, we tend to forget that there are many different types of sources. Information has no intrinsic good or bad value on its own, but we can determine the usefulness and appropriateness of sources by looking at different criteria such as the content, author, audience, and purpose. Our job is to look at the sources and determine which sources best fit our research purpose. The sources can also blend into one another, creating a spectrum of sources with a lot of gray areas. The four source types we'll be looking at are entertainment, general news, specialist publications, and scholarly. Entertainment sources are popular or sensational sources. Some examples of entertainment sources are BuzzFeed, National Examiner, and Vanity Fair. These sources tend to be about general interest topics and points of entertainment. The authors of these sources tend to be journalists and paparazzi with writing and entertainment experience. The audience for these sources is pretty much everyone in the general public, so entertainment sources are very accessible and easy to understand. The purpose of these sources is to entertain, promote, or advertise and sell, so they do what they can to capture anyone's attention. Next up on the spectrum are general news sources. Some examples of these include The Economist, National Geographic, and USA Today. These sources are typically about current events such as natural disasters, politics, or anything else that is happening in the world. The authors of these sources can be journalists, editorial staff, scholars, or freelance writers that have experience writing about current events. General news sources have a broad audience of concerned citizens who want to be informed about what is going on in the world, so they tend to be easy to understand. The purpose of these sources is to inform people and provide current information. The next type of source we want to look into is specialist publications, such as Quilting Arts Magazine and The American Biology Teacher. These sources are usually more focused because they contain hobby and career-specific information. The people who write these sources are usually individuals with experience in the field or are professionals. Either way, they have authority on the topics being discussed. The audience is also more narrowed because these are sources aimed toward people with similar interests or hobbies, or they work in the same field. The purpose of specialist publications is to educate so they can be useful if you want to learn about a specific field. The last type of source we'll look into are scholarly sources, such as the Journal of Water Sanitation and Transgender Studies Quarterly. These sources are very specific to a narrow area of research. For instance, a study on the hibernation patterns of grizzly bears or the feminist heroines of Jane Austen's literature. The people who write these types of publications are experts with academic credentials, typically PhDs, and are written for professionals and experts in the field along with college students like yourselves. Scholarly sources are also known as peer-reviewed sources and academic sources. The purpose of scholarly sources is to move the profession forward or gain a new understanding of the subject area. By looking at this completed spectrum, we can see how these categories for content, author, audience, and purpose can help us evaluate sources to determine how useful the sources you find are going to be. Considering the content, author, audience, and purpose of sources will help you determine which sources best fit your research purpose and improve your information literacy skills. If you need help finding sources or with research help in general, you can always ask a librarian. Go to library.usu.edu and click on Meet with a Librarian for more information.